My name's Leathur Rokk. Welcome to my channel. Today, I want to give you somewhat of an update on that homeless couple and their cat that I'm trying to get fixed. Stay tuned for the latest. I saw the homeless couple a couple of times since my last video, and they gave me some more information so that it will be easier for me to find them when I'm out and about. I can certainly understand one of their predicaments is they don't want to be too obvious to people who or maybe see from their cars or maybe different kinds of people that might not know them well. And you have to, when you're in a vulnerable position like they're in, you really have to be discreet. And so they have to do that while still being able to be seen by the people who are trying to help them. So I can understand them having to try to tread that balance. And there are a few trustworthy people who also know that they are in a situation and they need help. So I am in contact with some more people. Oh, I'm getting a breeze now. I have a little screen open up in my room, and it is a nice day. It is 71 degrees. It's not too bad, but I'm telling you, the sun out there, and they're all in the shade, and their cat was asleep today, and I didn't want to disturb him. He was curled up, and, you know, I didn't want to attract the attention of them to other people walking around. I gave him an extra bottle of water that I had. I actually set aside some dry food for them, and I hid them on my own cats so that they don't, you know, anything that's close to their noses, things have to be high up in such a way that they will, I've seen cats do to food, they'll rip it open, you know, bag of treats and dry food and stuff. So, but if I'd had that dry food with me, I would have dropped it off for the couple. I really want to try and see about getting, I want to get some more quotes on the cost to neuter a male cat and see what qualifies a person for low cost. I would like to think that people that are living on the street, whose things are in a shopping cart, I would think those people who have had a cat since it was a kitten, who demonstrated this whole time that they have been feeding and watering and protecting this cat this whole time, and it probably would have made their life a lot easier if they didn't have the responsibility of this life, but they have. And, you know, having a pet makes it, it limits your options with housing. So many places say no pets. And I can't tell you how many homes that my family and I lived in when I was little that a little white lie was told to the landlord so that we could sneak the cat in. Because, you know, you don't treat animals like they're all of a sudden an inconvenient, not really family member once things get to be a bit of a challenge. And every time I see, I see that they have a clean water and food bowl for that cat and everything. I try to give them water that is not terribly, terribly warm and disgusting. You know, it's just sometimes I go several days between not seeing them and I don't have things, if I say knew exactly where they were going to be and I had water in my refrigerator, then I would take it out there and give it to them. But they gave me some more ideas of other places where I can find them. And I need to be able to devote some time to researching some other places besides this Humane Society in Pleasantville. I just don't really have a whole lot of time to make a lot of phone calls right now because there's other things I'm dealing with. I have to find a local dentist because I only got half a course of antibiotics, and so that's manifesting for me in a bad way right now. And anyway, I have other things to deal with, so I really, being able to try and call, spend a bunch of time trying to find a new dentist on top of all that, I don't have time to do. So needless to say, I haven't really been able to spend much time to this cat situation. But at least I know easier places where I can find the people involved. I made sure that the routes of all the different routes I can take to go to different things like medical appointments and stuff, I make sure that passing them is one of the ways that I do it so that I can check up on them at least twice a day when I am in that direction. So they know that I'm working on it, and I need to get some quotes before I can arrange. And then also have I have to clean out. I have a carrier, but it really needs to be sterilized. And turns out it needs to be actually taken apart. And really, it's not the sort of thing that I want to do here in our house right now. I'm really overwhelmed by a whole lot of things. It's just trying to coordinate things for not just myself, but my mother. It's kind of, I'm not complaining, but it's a lot of work. But yet, I feel really good about knowing that instead of wallowing in my own pity parties or stressed out about health or stressing out about finances, I can think of somebody else who's such a small amount of resources would make such a big impact in their life. And it really puts my things in perspective. And if just getting their cat fixed will lift, that's kind of almost like when I decided to quit drinking, the kind of positive impact it made in my life. It made so many things easier and smoother for me. It was a logical thing that just made sense. And if they get their cat fixed, that will take care of that issue for them. Then they will be less likely to be worried about this cat being aggressive, and now maybe one person at a time can watch the cat, so the other person can do certain fulfill kind of job search kind of responsibilities or whatever a person, whatever. You see, I don't know enough about their own situation to make assumptions about what they may have not been able to deal with because of all the babysitting of the cat and stuff. I don't know. Everybody, that's the thing, is people are making assumptions about lifestyles and stuff of that couple, and it's really, nobody has a right to do that. You can't look at people and assume that there's substance issues or that there's anything else like that. I have not seen anything with my own eyes suggesting anything like that. But that said, just, you know. And if a person shouldn't be faulted for smoking tobacco, if they've been smoking that for 10, 20 years, that's one of the hardest addictions to break. So what are you going to do? Tell a person that all of a sudden they have to get a handle on that because that's an expensive addiction? I mean, I haven't hoed that row before, so I don't know what that's like. I think when you're in a compromised housing situation, the whole idea is to make your cost of your own personal living to be as cheap as possible. So cutting down on and or eliminating all bills is the best thing in the world, I think. Obviously, the less bills, the easier it is to be able to afford to live on practically nothing. So, but yeah, I gotta get some more quotes on different places so that I can find out how much it can cost. I'm saying as much as $90 to neuter a male cat. Come on, that I got to be able to get cheaper than that. These people were living on the street. Their stuff is in a shopping cart. They're looking for a place to wash their clothes and stuff. So they can get food. They can get cat food. They can get water. But I need to find out some better quotes on also transportation to Atlantic City, kind of to around. Close to the casinos in Midtown area. Because a couple, they're not going to just trust any old person to go and take their cat away for a couple hours or whatever, and everything. And they're kind of on the defensive. They don't know who's got their best interests at heart and whatever. But yes, cat needs to be fixed. And somebody told me today that one day a month they're supposed to be, I thought it was, they're confusing that with a rabies clinic. But the cat needs to be fixed, and when I get more information, I will make another video about it. Oh, it is so hot. I guess you want to see my kitties, don't Oh, she complains, and when you talk back to her, she cannot respond to your response. Oh, but she just passed gas. Oh no, you're a gassy kitty. No. Oh no, we will not have gassy kitties in my house. Oh no. Whew. My tabby boy, and he's fragrance free. That's a really great quality. I love to have a cat. A kitty that does not come with any fragrance. You can pick him up and not have to worry about squashing your tummy, making somebody have some of those odoriferous emanations. such as I got treated to with Cassie. Cassie, the garden cat. Tate, she smells like she's Cassie that ate beans from the garden. I'm wondering, why does she sneeze so bad? I never noticed that before. And she's silent but deadly, you know. Tabby boy, he has not fragranced me. Thank you for being a good boy. Yes, thank you for not doing that gassy stuff, right? Only Cassie's allowed to be gassy, right? Oh, my baby. Thank you for watching my latest cat video. If you like this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up. If you like me and my content, consider subscribing. And if you do, hit the bell so it looks like it's ringing. You won't miss anything I post. And hopefully, I will have some good news about cats. Stay tuned. Bye.